Now, it's our first numbers game, and Neil, you get to pick.
I'll stick with my one from the top, and then the other five, please.
Yeah, boring. What? No, this is going to be an interesting one from the top. Thank you, Neil. I should say it with more enthusiasm. I'll get fired. All right, the little numbers are 8, 5, 3, 3, 6, and 50. Come on, numbers. The target, 185.
185, and here is the clock. Did you get your 185?
No, I just got 186.
Oh, and Bobby?
185, I think.
Hey, how did you do it?
Potentially. 50 plus 6 plus 3. 59. Times by 3.
Times by 3 is 177.
And then plus 8.
Plus 8. Well done, 185. Whoa.
So, with the scores at 5 for Neil and 15 for Bobby, it's time for a tea time teaser. And the teaser is home sale. And the clue is it's going to pour with frozen rain. It could be good for me. That is, it's going to pour with frozen rain. It could be good for me. See you in a minute. Welcome back. I left you with the clue, it's going to pour with frozen rain. It could be good for me. The answer is hailsome. Now, Bobby, it's your choice of numbers.
Two large, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Bobby. Two large, four little, and we know you're good at maths if you're a poker player. Let's test it. Four little ones, 3, 8, 2, 10, and the big ones, 175. And the target. I'm going to sit down. 108.
I've got it.
108. And here comes the clock. How did you do?
A bit of a struggle, but 108.
Cool. OK, Neil?
Yeah, 108.
Ay, ay, ay. How did you do it?
100.
Uh-huh.
Plus 8.
Why are you asking Moira? I'm the numbers expert.
I thought you were going to test me, but, you know.
Was it the same for you?
Yeah, I don't even want to check it at all.
I won't check that one.
Rachel, shall I just keep stubbing going?
Yeah, let's move along.
All right. OK. Neil, it's your choice of numbers.
Can I have one from the top?
I thought you might have gambled. You're 24 points behind.
I'm just good at maths, so keep it simple.
You're just here for the fun, then. Right, we've got one poker player and one large picker. OK, the five little ones this time. 3, 9, 10, 8, 4, and the big one, 75. And the target, 711.
711, and your 30 seconds start now. So, Neil, are you on target?
Yeah, 7-11.
Ooh, and?
Yep, 7-11.
And you got that how?
75 minus 4.
75 minus 4, 71.
Times by 10.
Times 10, 7, 10.
And then 9 minus 8 is 1.
Yep, one way to get there.
Neil?
Yeah, this is where. Yeah.
actually, Moira, you know I said I'd teach you how to do the numbers?
Tell me.
Well, there's a trick for this one.
Oh, OK.
If you add the digits of any number up, so this one, if you add 7 plus 1 plus 1, that equals 9. If this number's in the 9 times table, then this number is divisible by 9. So you could have just said 75 plus 4 is 79 and times it by 9 to get 7 and 11. So I'll lock you in a room later and explain it to you slightly more slowly and you'll get it.
But that means you've got to have your 7 times table or your 9 times table.
Just, it's a trick for the nines. Once you know the numbers a little bit, you can see that that's divisible by 9 and then you can look at it and put your feet up for the next 29 seconds.
One day I'm going to make you proud. And with the scores at 31 for Neil and 55 for Bobby, here's today's second teaser. The teaser is snail peg. And the clue? You'd better be quick. Time is running out. You'd better be quick. Time is running out. See you in a minute. Welcome back. I left you with the clue, you'd better be quick, time is running out. And the answer? Elapsing. Bobby, it's your choice for the final numbers.
I'm going to go 4 large, please.
Oh. We're going all in. 4 from the top and 2 little. I like your style. Here we go. 2 small ones for the final time today. 3 and 8. And the big ones, as we know, 50, 25, 175. On the button, 842.
Oh.
8:42, and off we go. So, Bobby, how did you do?
I've got 843 not written down.
And Neil?
I've got 844.
Bobby?
100 times 8.
100 by 8. 800.
75 divided by 25.
Is 3.
And then times by 3.
Is 9.
And then 50 minus the 9 is, that's 841, and it needs to be 843.
There is. It's one the other way. I often do that. I know where your brain went, but unlucky, I'm afraid.
Neil, how about you?
It was similar. 100 times 8 is 800.
800.
Add 50.
850.
75 divided by 25. And then for some reason, I added it to the 3. to take it away to get 844.
Yep, 2 away.
Rachel, is it possible?
It is possible with this one. You could have said 25 times 3 is 75, divided by the 75 is 1, and then 100 take away 1 is 99, times that by 8 for 792, and add on the 50 for 842.
Professor Rachel, thank you. And so with the scores at 45 for Neil and 78 for Bobby, it's time for the final round. Fingers on buzzers. Please reveal today's countdown conundrum. Bobby.
Blundered.
Let's have a look. There's no stopping you. Bobby, you are amazing. Now, commiserations for Neil, but we're sending you on your way with a goodie bag and a teapot. And have you had a good time?
I've had a great time. Thanks very much. And I mean, very well done to Bobby as well.
Absolutely. Cheers. But you were the 3 times winner, and I think you're amazing anyway, as well as Bobby. And congratulations to you, Bobby. We'll see you tomorrow. So it's goodbye to Susie and to the extraordinary man they call Biggins. and so to Rachel. I just am overwhelmed by your amazing abilities. Thank you very much.
Well, my math abilities are almost as good as my 10-year segue abilities as well. So we can link Bobby to Poker Face, to Lady Gaga, and we're back to Freddie Mercury.
Now, that is pretty darn good. Wow.
Radio Gaga. There
like I said, Professor, many thanks to you for watching, and goodbye.